not speak of him. But if it becomes like a fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. Do these words not perhaps describe St. Ignatius? I recall that, of course, with Father Dave Fleming, who's incidentally mentioned in your little pamphlet. And he would begin his course on St. Ignatius and spiritual exercises by asking the question, if you had to summarize St. Ignatius in one word, maybe a phrase, but one word, what word would that be? You all know St. Ignatius, you're all friends of Ignatius, or formation experiences we've had through the high school, through the White House. What would you say about St. Ignatius? What word describes him best? I recall our classmates, all Jesuits in formation, development house, and our responses about innovator, St. Ignatius innovator, St. Ignatius the organizer, St. Ignatius passionate one, man of passion. All three statements. And then Father Fleming explained to us, one person actually got it, but he said, I would argue that St. Ignatius, the one word that describes him best is love. Someone who is radically in love with God. And it changed everything in his life. It was this fire burning in his heart. It was this passion that was like imprisoned in his bones when he came to know Christ. He was knocked off his high horse, if you will, of his own desires, and how he wanted to live his life. And he began to see Christ. He fell more and more in love with Christ. And it dictated everything he did for the rest of his life. Love became his motivator. St. Ignatius, indeed, I think that is a great insight. St. Ignatius was a great lover, first and foremost. He was filled with the love of God, and he wanted to spread that love however best he could, however most effectively he could. As we read in the second reading, that everything should be done, whether you eat or drink, whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God. Ad maiorem Dei gloria, St. Ignatius would know. He could have written these words, huh? Do everything for the glory of God, even as wolves for eating and drinking. We won't cover those right now. But everything for the glory of God, everything. He was so filled with the love of God that he wanted his whole life to be ordered for God's glory. He knew that he was called out of himself. We don't find ourselves unless we lose ourselves, as Jesus tells us. And St. Ignatius clearly lost himself. He lost himself in love. And that is our invitation too. We don't find ourselves until we lose ourselves. I was with a friend this last weekend from El Paso, and she has cerebral palsy, had it from birth, and has two lovely children, and she's of Indian descent. And so whenever they use the word Mary, they don't say Mary. In India, you may know this, they say Mother Mary. Everything's Mother Mary, which is a beautiful phrase. So she's taught her little three-year-old Gabby to pray. And so Gabby prays, doesn't really know exactly what she's saying, but she says, Jesus, I love you. Mother Mary, I love you. Make me holy. And so I saw this video of a girl doing that. And the mother was telling me, whenever she says, I love you, Gabby, Gabby will not respond, I love you, Mommy. She goes into this philosophy, I love you, Gabby. And she goes into, Jesus, I love you, Mary. I love you, Mother Mary. So she, when she's filled with the love of God, she can't help but start loving. And she loves the saints, and she loves God, and she loves everyone, because she's filled with God's love. And that's a good model for you and me. In other words, we're made for love. We're made to give of ourselves. And Ignatius found his gifts by falling in love, letting himself fall in love. With this uncontrollable passion, if you will, that pervaded him, that motivated him. line or a White House. It's about order and practicality and good finances and responsibility. Those are not our models. Those are part and parcel of our mission, but they're not the center of our mission. Our mission is to help people fall in love with the love of God. To help them let go and fall in love. In the gospel today, Jesus speaks of every disciple has to be willing to give up everything to follow God. St. Ignatius had this passion for going around the world, for being a missionary, and yet God called him to stay in Rome and to be the general for so many years. That's tough. When you have this passion, you go out and you want to be the one sent up. And you don't want to be the general. He was not the kind who was like, I would think I would be a good organizer of this wonderful work that God has begun here. He didn't want it. He tried to advocate himself several times, but he kept being re-voted in. And he listened to his brothers who said, Father Ignatius, we need you to be our general. We need you to give us a lead while you're still alive. So he accepted that. St. Ignatius, we have more letters, 7,000, from him than from any other person of that period. He had to be a letter writer there in Rome, over and over, copying, transcribing letters. But doing that out of love, things that you and I would find very boring, and I bet he found boring too. He did them with love. He did them with zeal. He said no to himself and his own desires. Every one of us who does not renounce our possessions cannot be Christ's disciples. Then Ignatius said, he was a great disciple. We pray for his intercession today, that you and I would be more and more inspired by that charism of love. Really fall in love. Let myself fall in love with God. Do not count the cost. To what to give. I'm made to give. I need to surrender myself. You and I are at our best when we're giving ourselves, we're surrendering ourselves, we're giving everything for God's sake. Let's pray for that grace through this Eucharist. You and I would be inspired to give everything. To be able to make those words of Jesus our own. This is my body given up.